a year marked by atropic forces, including both unfortunate political developments and large natural catastrophes, SCOR once again demonstrates its ability to weather shocks and to continue to create superior value for its shareholders. The group has profitably expanded and deepened its franchise in 2018, achieving a normalized return on equity in line with the Vision in Action target and a robust solvency position at the end of the year in the upper part of the optimal range. The most significant political risk that struck the group last year was the fiscal reform in the US, which was introduced in the very last days of 2017 and includes a provision that taxes reinsurance premiums ceded to affiliated foreign subsidiaries. SCOR restructured its operations in 2018 to mitigate the impact of the fiscal reform and hence maintain its competitiveness going forward. Similarly, Brexit has been an additional complication. We have prepared for the worst, a hard Brexit, by creating a new Paris-based P&C insurance company to ensure the continuity of the services offered to our clients in the EU. The reinsurance industry now dedicates much of its attention, effort, energy, and resources to dealing with these kinds of issues pertaining to the refragmentation of the world, i.e. the ongoing sharpening of political, international, and social tensions. SCOR nimbleness allows it to find appropriate solutions when faced with these anthropic forces. As far as acts of gods are concerned, Mother Nature has also been quite agitated in 2018, with two destructive hurricanes in the US, Michael and Florence, two powerful typhoons in Japan, Jebi and Trami, and two wildfires in California, and other smaller events across various perils and regions. Managing such risks and covering these kinds of events is her raison d'être, her mission. We are here to help citizens and societies face this risk. We are there to alleviate the negative impact of these risks when they occur. And at SCOR, we are proud, very proud, that during the second consecutive year of elevated natural catastrophe activity, we once again have been able to accomplish a mission while managing to deliver a solid set of results. SCOR recorded a net income of €322 million, while the group's estimated solvency ratio at the end of 2018 reached 215%, in the upper part of the optimal range of 185-220% defined in a Vision in Action plan. Furthermore, SCOR's underlying profitability is excellent, as demonstrated by the group's normalized return on equity, which stands at 9.4%, and hence exceeds the target of 800 basis points above the 5-year risk-free rate set out in Vision in Action. Meanwhile, SCOR continued to expand and deepen its franchise in 2018. It achieved strong endogenous growth, with gross written premiums reaching €15.3 billion, up 7.1% at constant exchange rates compared to 2017. This growth was well balanced between both of the group's business engines, SCOR Global P&C and SCOR Global Life. SCOR's growth potential, long-term value creation capability, and shock absorbing capacity are confirmed year after year. SCOR is also pursuing its strong shareholder remuneration policy. A cash dividend of €1.75 per share will be proposed at the next annual general meeting at the end of April. Looking forward, SCOR's ambition is intact, and we have every confidence in the group's ability to continue its solvent and profitable growth in the years ahead. SCOR is uniquely positioned to significantly benefit from the positive long-term trends that the reinsurance industry offers. Meanwhile, the group is on the move and actively preparing for the future. We constantly improve our tools, our processes, and our models. We are supporting the only credible blockchain initiative in the insurance sector, and we are partnering with numerous insurtechs around the world to see what innovations are going to emerge and shape the insurance and reinsurance world of tomorrow. The group has tremendous potential for continued profitable growth and long-term value creation as a global Tier 1 reinsurer. SCOR is an independent company, and we are master of our own destiny. We are actively preparing our next 3-year strategic plan, which will be presented in September. This will be an opportunity for SCOR to confirm its objectives and to set out the ways and means chosen to achieve these. Leveraging a T1 status, leveraging a global and deep franchise, leveraging a prime rating, and leveraging expertise-driven human capital. SCOR's successful story goes on.